Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dean Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 5.2, Problem 4. This is Section 5.2, Problem 4. It says, Linda starts saving for retirement when she was 21 years old. She saves $40 every month at 12% compounded monthly. How much will she have by the time she's 65? And again, I pick 65 because it's typically a retirement age. $40 every month is really not a lot of money. I mean, it's just a little more than a dollar a day. So it's not that much to save. So let's see what we come up with. First of all, this is an annuity question because we know how much we're saving and we calculate the end amount. The annuity formula is A equals P times some brackets, and in the brackets we have 1 plus r over m to the m times t. There's a minus 1 after that and an r over m in the denominator. Now, as we fill that in, A equals the P is the regular savings, which for this is $40. And then the brackets have a numerator and a denominator. And in the numerator, we have in parentheses 1 plus r over m. So the 1, of course, is just 1. The r, the rate, as a decimal, 12% goes into the formula as 0.12. And over m, the m is how often you compound per year. So because this is monthly compounding, m is 12, 12 months in a year. You close the parentheses. You have an exponent of m times t. So m is 12, again, for monthly compounding. Now the t is, again, not 65. That's a common mistake. That's how old Linda is when she'll stop the investment. But she doesn't start at age birth, at age zero. She starts at age 21. So 21 years to age 65, there's a span of 44 years. So that's the t. The investment is for 44 years, and there's a minus 1 at the end of the numerator in the brackets. And in the denominator, r over m, again, r is 0.12, the rate is a decimal. M is 12, the number of times compounded per year. And again, for monthly compounding, m would be 12. So the formula is filled in now, and next I'll just start some of the computation. I'm going to start in my parentheses, what I usually do. So A equals, there's a 40 in front of the brackets, and in the brackets we have a numerator and a denominator. Now, in the numerator, in my parentheses, 1 plus 0.12 over 12. The 0.12 divided by 12 is 0.01. Again, it can be done on a calculator easily enough, 0.12 divided by 12. But I know 12 over 12 is 1, and it's not 12 over 12. That's a 1, and I have to adjust for the decimal. That's why it's 0.01, two places. And I'm going to add 1 to that. So the 0.01 plus 1, in my parentheses, I have 1.01. Now, my exponent, 12 times 44, well, 10 44s is 440, but I don't have 10, I have two more, so it's another 88. So it should be 528 for my exponent. Again, you can verify that with a calculator. I feel pretty comfortable, you know, I'll do tricks like that sometimes. And then in the denominator of my brackets, 0.12 over 12, again, is just 0.01. Without the one in front, I like to point out that the denominator and the numerator of the brackets will have the same decimal, but in the numerator there's a 1 in front of the decimal, but not in the denominator. So the next thing I have to do to finish the computation is calculate the really big exponent on the parentheses. So in the next part of the formula that I calculate, I'm going to have A equals 40 times some brackets, and in the brackets I'm going to get some result from my big exponent. There's going to be a minus 1 at the end of the number, and then the denominator is still 0.01. So let's figure out what that big number is. That's not something I'd do without a calculator. So it's 1.01 times itself 528 times. So I'm going to put in the 1.01 in my calculator, press the exponent button of my calculator, enter the exponent of 528. It equals, and the calculator tells me it's 191.28 something. So now in my brackets, I'm going to have A equal, overall in the formula, A equals 40 times in the brackets. The numerator is going to have 191.2869565. There's a minus 1 after that, and then a 0.01 in the denominator. So the minus 1 is easy. I'll finish off the top of my brackets. The 191 point something is going to be 190 point something. So the next part of the process, I'm going to have 40 times some brackets, and the top of the brackets, 190.2869565. And I will divide that by 0.01. And now, in the brackets, I'll do the division, the 190.286965 divided by 0.01. That'll give me one number in the brackets, and I'll still have a times 40 in front of those brackets. So to get the brackets down to one number, again, I'm going to do 190.286956 divided by 0.01. And that's going to give me 190.286965. And that number is times 40. So I have the number that I have for the brackets, so 190.286956 on the screen of my calculator, and I'll do times 40 because there's a times 40 in front of it. And the final answer comes out to 761147.8259. Now, because this answer represents money, I don't want to have four places after my decimal. I'd like to round it to just two. So the 0.825 something is enough to make it 0.83 or 83 cents. So the final answer will be $761,147.83. So if Linda saves a fairly small amount, $40 every month, she'll wind up with $761,000, even a little bit more, after 44 years by the time she retires. So she's saving very little, but starting at a very young age, age 21. And you'll see in the next problem, we compare this to Linda's brother, who starts saving much later in life, but much more every month. And what you'll find out is Linda comes out way ahead. So we'll see that in problem 5.